بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
رمضان Picks.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Praise be to Allah and may the best peace and blessings be upon His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Brothers and sisters, welcome to another episode of Ramadan Picks. Today, inshallah, we'll be speaking about one of the very beautiful attributes of Allah the Almighty, which is al-afw. Many people confuse between al-afw and al-maghfirah, and that is simply because they're very close. And when it comes to the translation of both, sometimes they are written as forgiveness, translated as forgiveness. In fact, there is a specific extra meaning when it comes to al-afw over al-maghfirah or forgiveness. Let's learn together the meaning of both and the difference. But before, we would like to learn why this quality is so great and it delivers such glad tidings and good news. In the sound hadith, when the mother of the believers, Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Prophet of Allah, if I figure out that tonight is Laylatul Qadr, which dua is best to recite during this night? He said, Ya Aisha, you should say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'fu anna. There is another narration which says, Allahumma innaka afuun ghafurun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'fu anna, which means, O Allah, you are afu, you are the one who pardons. Ghafur, you are the one who forgives. Fa'fu anna, so pardon us and forgive us our sins. In order to learn the difference between al-afw and al-maghfira, we need to look into the Arabic dictionary. The word al-afw, the Arab used to say afat al-rih, when the wind blows, and accordingly it covers up the traces of the footprints. So al-afw is simply removing all the traces of the sins, while al-maghfira is simply forgiving the sins. Again, so what is so special about al-afw? When Allah the Almighty honors the servant who was just a sinner and He grants an al-afw or pardoning, that sin will be eliminated from the record of his bad deeds. It will not show anymore. Not even the angels who recorded that sin will have an access to see it. That is the main difference between al-afw and al-maghfara. So al-maghfara is forgiveness. Al-afw is pardoning. The sin would not appear in the record anymore, even to the angels who recorded that sin. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam highly recommended that if it is Laylatul Qadr, where the dua is most likely to be accepted, where if you happen to be praying, all your previous sins will be forgiven. Furthermore, recite this invocation. Oh Allah, you are pardoning, you are forgiving, you love to pardon. You love to pardon, yes, Allah the Almighty loves to forgive His servant sins. We find in Surah At-Taghabun, Allah the Almighty encourages the believers to pardon and to forgive. So He says in ayah number 14 of Surah At-Taghabun, وَإِن تَعْفُوا وَتَصْفَحُوا وَتَغْفِرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And if you were to pardon and forgive, Allah the Almighty, indeed, He is the most forgiving, the most merciful. So when you pardon, you will be pardoned. When you forgive, you will be forgiven. And Allah the Almighty in Surah Al-A'raf, it's a beautiful chapter, in ayah number 199, ordered Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be afu, and similarly his followers. So when he said, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. O Muhammad, peace be upon him. And the command is not exclusively for him, rather for him and all his followers. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ, deal with pardoning, be pardoning, be forgiven. وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ, and enjoin what is good. وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ, and turn away from the ignorant ones. Even those who deal with you foolishly, turn away from them, pardon them, and forgive them. If we forgive, we will be eligible for forgiveness. The last but not the least, the greatest news in the Quran, as Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, said, أَرْجَى آيَة فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ, the greatest ayah in the entire book of Allah, when it comes to forgiveness, is the ayah of Surah Az-Zumar, in which Allah the Almighty calls upon whom? Doesn't call upon the righteous, doesn't call about the great believers, rather He calls upon the sinners, those who committed sins to the extent that they transgress against themselves, but they are still His servants, when they turn to Allah with repentance. and he begging for forgiveness, they would definitely find him the forgiving, the most merciful. The ayah says,
قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا
إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ.
Say, O my servants, those who transgress against themselves, they have committed all kind of sins. Still, despair not of Allah's mercy. Do not lose hope. Rather, be optimistic. Seek forgiveness. Turn unto Allah with sincere repentance. And our most beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, none of you shall enter paradise simply because of your good deeds or righteousness. They said, even you, O Prophet of Allah. They said, even me, unless if Allah covers me with His mercy. We invoke Allah as His Prophet taught us, اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتجاوز عن سيئاتنا. I would like to remind you that الدل على الخير كفاعله. When you share this episode or any other good episode with others and they benefit out of it, you will get a similar word to those who produced it, to the speaker, to everyone who invested in it. So do not forget to share this episode with as many people as possible. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.